I'm Reverend Sam, and this is Power Encounter TV broadcast. I pray for you today that the visitation of heaven will be your testimony. In the name of Jesus, I pray that this year as you hear the voice of God from my mouth, I pray the hand of God will lift you up to the peak, to the level that is beyond human understanding. I pray in the name of Jesus, grace and mercy will find you and lift you up from the dungeon of life to sit among the princes. Lord, let your mercy do it for your people. I vow to give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. You see, the message of today, I had it in Yoruba. You know, when the mercy of God find you, invisible hand of God will be orchestrating events and circumstances. Things that you think are coincidental will become divine appointment, divine strategic positioning for you to enter into divine purpose. I want us to use the story of King Saul. You see, because Saul never knew that he was going to be the king of Israel. But God already spoke to Prophet Samuel that by this time tomorrow, I'm going to bring the next king of Israel to you. Now, let's not look at that, because as far as Saul was concerned, he did not know that there was any word that had been spoken to the prophet concerning him. Now, what happened was that Kish, his father, has some of his asses straight off. They got lost. So Kish called Saul and said, "Saul, I want you and your servant to go look for my asses that are lost." And the Bible says that, you know, that was like an ordinary errand that is given to him by his father. But you see, what he did not know is that the mercy of God already found him. The strain of those asses were part of God's prophetic, how do I call it, prophetic positioning for him to be able to live where he was, to where the word of God will come upon his life to lift him to the next level. You are watching me today, maybe by coincidence. Maybe this is your first time of watching me. I don't think anything is coincidence with my life and my ministry. I believe anyone whose heart is open to my word is because God has created a connection between us, like that of David and Jonathan. Anyone who find the word of God in my mouth simple to understand, I believe it is because I've been anointed as a prophet for your destiny. And therefore, I will encourage you that you open up your heart and receive this mercy. Remember, the Bible says he sent forth his word and his word healed them, and his word delivered them from all their destructions. The reason why people never amount to anything in life is because Satan has chosen to make them to look away from the path of destiny. But this day, I see heaven open. This is literally what I saw. I saw what looked like, you know, in the village where you have fire, you know, when you are making wood as fire, then you have those sparks. Pa, 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 that's what I saw from heaven. And I'm like, why is fire falling from heaven? And I did not know the meaning. That's why I didn't say it in the prayer. But right now, God said to me, that is like the fire that came upon the apostle in Acts of the Apostle. And God said it is because it's time for God to anoint some people. And whatever has made your destiny to become redundant, that fire will melt every shaft. And you begin to see the brightness of your glory shining from this very moment. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to know that was what happened to Saul. His father said, "I want you to go and look for the asses that are lost." And then him himself and his servant went away to go and look for the asses that are lost. And they went everywhere, they couldn't find it. In fact, Saul gave up. He was about to go when the servant said, "Why don't you go check the man of God out? I heard there's a prophet of God in this land, and he will show us the way to go." And Saul said, "But we don't have an offering to give to him." And the servant said, "I have a quarter of a shekel here. You can give him that one." And then they went ahead and went straight towards the place where Samuel was. And then in 1 Samuel chapter 9, I'm reading verse 18. Then Saul approached Samuel in the gate and said, "Tell me, where is the house of the seer?" Samuel answered Saul, "I am the seer. Go up before me to the high place, for today you shall eat with me." You see, comfort. God is bringing you to comfort this day. I am coming to your life, into your house, with a heavy prophetic word from God in my mouth, letting you know that the time for affliction is over. The time for suffering is over. God is bringing comfort to you in the name of Jesus. He said, go before me to the high place, for today shall eat with me. And in the morning, I will let you know and tell you all that is in your mind. As for the donkey that were lost 3 days ago, do not set your mind on them, for they have been found. Wow. And for whom is all that is desirable in Israel? Is it not for you and for all your father's house? When Prophet Samuel said that all the desires of Israel is coming to you, Saul answered, am I not a Benjamite from the least of all the tribe of Israel? And is not my clan the humblest of all the clans of the tribe of Benjamin? Why then have you spoken to me in this way? You see, when God wants to lift up people, God always does that by lifting up people that have been declared hopeless. God derives joy in using his mighty hand to lift men from merry clay and make them to sit among the princes. And I believe that in the name of Jesus, as your heart is open to the word of God today, that fire, those flames of fire I saw from heaven, they will touch your life today. Something will be ignited in your being. And from this very day, suddenly your intelligence will open up. Suddenly you begin to think straight. Suddenly you begin to find the way forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Wow. Now let's look at verse 22. Then Samuel took Saul and his young man and brought them into the hall and gave them a place at the head of those who had been invited. Can you see that? Saul was not invited, his servant was not invited, but by the mercy of God, because the mercy of God has predestined him for greatness. The Bible says that an exalted seat that has been prepared was given to him and his servant. In fact, he was exalted above those who have been invited. I believe God that by the anointing of God that is following this word, I'm also receiving that message, that God Almighty will lift you higher than those who think they are higher than you. God will make those who have been oppressing you to become people that you will be controlling and be directing at your will in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Look at verse 23. And Samuel said to the cook, bring the portion I gave you, of which I said to you, put it aside. So the cook took up the leg and what was on it and set them before Saul. And Samuel said, see, what was kept is set before you. Eat, because it was kept for you until the hour appointed. Wow. That you might eat with the guest. This, I felt in my heart to stop right here. Look at that verse. Prophet Samuel, who is the servant of God, said, see, what was kept is set before you. I believe that there are hidden riches of dark places that are set for me and that are set for you. And I believe that this is the appointed time and the appointed season. When the things that have been kept secret will begin to come of their own accord in the name of Jesus. I believe that in the name of Jesus, the Lord God will begin to connect you and I to our Jonathan. Do you know that Jonathan is the son of King Saul? I'm trying to fast forward because I want to prophetically pray for you. Saul has a son called Jonathan, and Jonathan became so rich because he was the heir to the throne, but David was nobody. But you know what happened? God made the heart of Jonathan to love David as his own soul, and Jonathan stripped himself naked and covered David with his garment. And I decree that in the name of Jesus, to everyone whose time has come, because there are times and seasons for everything under heaven, and God cannot bring everything to pass at once. But I'm sure that there are some people that will watch this program who will hear my voice, and your time has come, but the enemy has been keeping you away from your appointment. By the power of the Most High God, I command that the hand of God will move every enemy out of your way. The same way the mercy of God connected Saul to Samuel so that Saul can assume his kingship position. I decree this day, whatever power that has been moving you away from where your greatness has been preordained for you, I curse that hand, I curse that power, and I ask that the hand of God, the hand of mercy, will begin to push you towards the direction where your throne is, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, Samuel said, see, what was kept is set before you. Eat, because it was kept for you until the hour appointed. I use the authority of God in the name of Jesus to comfort every power, to comfort every honor, to comfort every glory that is appointed for you, which is due for this season. I call them to begin to manifest. I call them to begin to come to you. Hidden riches of dark places, ideas that will make you great, connection that will make life pleasurable for you, in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be. So shall it be. Because the prophet said, it has been kept until the hour appointed. But look at me. If you are not serving God with your whole life, it cannot happen. It cannot happen. Because you see, the enemy of your destiny is there. And the only way that you can be free from them is when you are completely connected to the Lord. So if you are one leg in the house of God, one leg outside, serving God with today and serving the devil tomorrow, you are not the one I'm talking about. I'm talking about those who have been weeping, those who have been looking up to God, those who have been saying, God, you are our deliverer. Nobody can deliver us except you. Lord, our faith and our hope is in you. I am talking about those people that do not have any man. You know, Jesus met that man by the pool of Bethesda, and the man said, I have no man. I am speaking to those men, and I am decreeing today that this day, the hand of God will reach out to you. And when you'll be angry, men like angels, they will reach out to you. Helpers will reach out to you, in the mighty name of Jesus. People who don't understand your language, I receive it, Lord. People that do not understand your language, they will just love you, and they will serve you with all of their opportunities, all of their privileges, in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. So shall it be. As you have set your heart to serve the Lord, I decree this day that God will cause nature to accommodate your greatness. In the name of Jesus. Your witness shall no more be a factor. Because from now, God will begin to celebrate your glory. And so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And amen. I believe that God has blessed you today. You will see the phone number on the screen, the email on the screen. You will see my Facebook link on my Facebook ID on the screen. I'd like you to let us know what God has done in your life. Now, I want you to know that I want you to connect with me on Facebook. Why? Because as a servant of God, when I stand in the office that God has given to me, God sent prophetic word through me, God sent teaching through me, God sent revelations through me. And I want to start blessing you, you know, just like you are watching me right now, I want to start blessing you on Facebook also. You will see the Facebook ID, Living Witness. Just type it, send me friend request, I will accept it, so that from now you can begin to be part of those who are enjoying the blessing that come from our live stream. I've got to go right now, but until I come here again next time, I don't want to ever forget that no matter what you have gone through in life, now that you're a child of God, one thing is very sure. The testimony of your life will be that you are one of, because Jesus is real. I see you next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Lord, you are great. Thunder announce your presence. The storm announce your power. I can't imagine your greatness.